the health community around the world in utter shock. The International AIDS Society says a number of its members were on board Malaysia Airlines Flight 17. They were heading to the AIDS 2014 conference in Melbourne, Australia, scheduled to start this Sunday. Typically attended by thousands from all over the world, and among them, leading HIV experts. Their loss likely to have an impact on research regarding diagnosing, treating, and curing the disease. Former President Bill Clinton is one of the keynote speakers at the conference. He says it's awful, sickening, what has happened to so many gifted people.
They were doing so much good. It's gathering. We do this on a regular basis, have these international AIDS conferences. And I try to go to all of them because I'm always so inspired by what other people are doing and what we can learn from them. And so since I left office, it's been a kind of a regular part of my life, thinking about those people being knocked out of the sky. It's pretty tough.
One of the victims, prominent Dutch scientist Joop Lange. I first met him in 2004 when he presided over the International AIDS Conference in Bangkok. Those who knew him say he was a hardcore scientist with the heart of an activist who worked tirelessly to get affordable AIDS drugs for HIV-positive patients living in poor countries. One small example of his work, he was the one that argued if Coca-Cola could get refrigerated beverages to places all over Africa, then we should be able to do the same with refrigerated HIV medications.
It's going to have a huge impact, both on people who worked closely with him, people in his lab, and on the society as a whole. It's an incredible loss. We're all just bracing ourselves to arrive and find out who else may have been on that flight. It's unbelievable. It's not really real yet.
The World Health Organization tells CNN that their spokesman, Glenn Thomas, was on board that doomed flight. He most recently worked with us here at CNN during our coverage of the Ebola outbreak in Guinea. A friend says he was a wonderful man doing great work in the world and was also planning his 50th birthday celebration. His life, and so many others, cut tragically short